Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and in high spirits. Today, we are going to study Class 3 Maths, a new chapter that is Give and Take. So let's start. I am Kittu. This is my home. Isn't it huge? It has 100 rooms. Will you help me in painting some of the rooms? Let's do it. Let's start from room 2. If we add 10 to 2 to reach room 12, how will we proceed? Now, to add 10 to 2, we can go all the way to the right up to 10. Here we go. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And then one more jump to 11 and another jump to 12. So we took 10 jumps to reach 12 from 2. Now this is one way to go from 2 to 12. Students, is there any other shortcut? Yes, of course. Follow me. We can jump upwards by one row. A jump from 2 to 12. Can you tell how many steps we have taken while jumping from 2 to 12? Yes, it is 10 jumps. So, one jump upward means 10 jumps forward. Now, try one jump up from 14. When we jump up from 14, we reach which number? Yes, it will be 24. So that means we have taken 10 jumps from 14 to 24. How have we proceeded? By just moving one row upwards. Now we color room number 24. Now, can you tell me how will I go from 22 to 41? We will jump two rows upwards from 22 to 32 and 32 to 42. That will be like 10 jumps forward and then one jump towards the left, that is from 42 to 41. That means we have moved 20 steps forward and one step back. So how many steps we have taken to reach 41 from 22? It's 20 minus 1, that is 19 steps. You can also go this way. First, we will move one step back from 22 to 21 and then two jumps upwards. from 21 to 31 and from 31 to 41. So thus we have moved upwards 2 jumps, that is 20 steps, and 1 jump backwards, that is minus 1 step. So 21 minus 1 is 19. Again we reached from 22 to 41 in 19 steps. Isn't it interesting? Let's move forward. Find my food. Students, let's go to Kittu's home and find some food. I hope you all are fond of food. Food is very essential because we can live, we can survive only by having food. Hey, I have something very interesting for you. Mother told me there are sweets to eat in some rooms. Help me find that room. First one is 10 less than 34. Now students, just think, 10 less than 34. So how will we reach to that room number? To reduce 10 steps, we will jump 1 step down from 34 to 24. And 1 step down will mean 10 steps back. So we reach 24. So 10 less than 34 is 24. Next is 53 minus 20. Now, to reduce 20 from 53, we will jump 1 step down from 53 to 43 and then 1 more step down to 33. So that means we reduced 20 from 53 and got 33. Next, you tell me, what is 11 more than 31? So now we first move 1 step upwards from 31 to 41 and then 1 step towards the right, that is forward, and we reach 42. So 11 more than 31 is 42. Next is 11 less than 66. So first we move down from 66 to 56. That is, we reduce 10 steps. And then one more step, we move backwards from 56 to 55. So that means we subtract 11 from 66 and what do we get? 55. One is 62 plus 13. So here is the number 62. We first add 10 by moving 1 step upwards and we reach which number? 72. And then we move 3 steps forward, 73, 74, and then we reach 75. So 62 plus 13 is 75. Next is 23 less than 89. So students, here we have the number 89. To reduce 23, first we reduce 20 by moving 2 steps down from 89 to 79 and then from 79 to 69, and then we go 3 steps back, 69 to 68, then 267, and then 266. So 23 less than 89 is 66. This way, you can do mental calculations on addition as well as subtraction. Now we see a number is 47. So we can write it as 37 plus 10. So that is, to reach 47, we will go from 37 to one row upwards, and we will reach 47. Next is 65 minus 30. 65 minus 30, we go to 65 and then go 3 rows down to reduce 30, and we reach which number? It's 35. So 65 minus 30 is 35. Next number is 46 plus 21. Now can you do it? Just think, how will you do it? 46 plus 21. First you will add 20 by moving 2 steps upwards, and you reach 66, and then 1 step forward, and you reach which number? 67. Next number is 87, and we have to reduce 30 from it. So reducing 30 means going 3 rows down, then we reach 77, 67 and 57. So 87 minus 30 is 57. Next, you do it yourself. 66 minus 11, and that is 55. 36 minus 9 is, just think, you do it yourself. 36 minus 9. So first you can reduce 10 from 36, and you reach 26, and then because we had to reduce 9 instead of 10, so we can now add 1 and we will reach 27. So 36 minus 9 is 27. So students, I hope you are enjoying this mental calculations, and see, without even counting on our fingers or on paper, we can add this very easily. Now, adding made easy. Anisha bought apples for 37 rupees. Raja bought bananas for 21 rupees. The woman who was selling fruits said, immediately, you have to give me 58 rupees. Both Anisha and Raja were very surprised. How did the lady calculate so fast? We cannot calculate that fast. So they asked the woman, how did you calculate it so easily and so fast? The woman who was selling fruits, she said, look, it's pretty easy. 37 is 30 and 7. And 21 is 20 and 1. So, I add 30 and 20 and get 50, and 7 and 1, I get 8. So 50 and 8 is 58. Isn't it easy? Yes, it's very easy. And this is the easiest way of adding numbers by breaking them into units and tens. students, you can also add it in the same way. Now let's try to add some other numbers. 26 plus 43. Now 26 is 20 plus 6 and 43 is 40 plus 3. Now we add 20 and 40 together and what do we get? We get 60. And then we add 6 and 3 together and what do we get? 9. Now we have to add 60 and 9. And what number do we get? 69. So this is very easy. Now let's add another number. It's 33 plus 56. Now 33 can be written as 30 plus 3. And 56 can be written as 50 plus 6. 30 and 50 together will make 80. And 3 and 6 together will make 9. So we add 80 and 9. And what do we get? Yes, 89. I hope you find this addition very interesting. Now I give you another number. It's 37 plus 22. So students, 37 can be written as 30 plus 7 and 22 can be written as 20 plus 2. 30 plus 20 makes 50 and 7 plus 2 makes 9. So we add 50 and 9 and what number do we get? It's 59. So 37 plus 22 gives 59. Students, now I give you another pair of numbers. It's 73 plus 24. 70 plus 3 will be 73 and 20 plus 4 will be 24. Now we add 70 and 20 and what do we get? 90. And 3 and 4 we add and we get 7. So we add 90 and 7 to get 97. Now students, let's move forward. Let's play a game now. It's
mango chili game. Roll a pair of dice and move by adding the numbers that come on the top of both the dice. Keep a different colored button for each player. If you reach a mango, you go forward. If you step on a chili, you will have to go back. Let's see who reaches back home first. Now game is very simple. Here are some numbers written and this is a pair of dice. One player will throw the dice, both the dice together and add the numbers that come on the top of both the dice. Then if his button fall on a mango, he will go forward. But if the button of a player falls on a chili, he or she will have to go back. This way, this game will move on and let's see who reaches home first. You can also play this game at your home and enjoy with your friends. Let's see, here are two players, Bunny and Johnny. Bunny rolls the dice first and see what he gets. He gets 7 and 5 on the two dices. So 7 plus 5 gives 12. So Bunny moves 12 steps forward. Now he places his button on 12. Now it's Johnny's turn. Johnny rolls the pair of dice and he gets 6 and 4. He will add 6 and 4 and what do we get? He will get 10. So he will move his button on 10. So this way both the players will continue the game and will see who reaches the home first. He or she will be the winner of the game. I would suggest you children can make such a game at your homes and play with your friends. Now let's move forward.
Now students, I'm giving you one more pair of numbers to add. Can you add them? I'm giving you time. You just think. It's 56 plus 21. So 56 can be written as 50 plus 6. And 21 can be written as 20 plus 1. So 50 and 20 makes 70. And 6 plus 1 makes 7. So 70 plus 7 gives what number? It's 77. I hope by now you will be feeling like experts in counting numbers like this. So now I'm giving you numbers. You have to do some quick calculations. First number is 33 plus 42. Just think its answer. I'm not gonna solve it for you now. Just think quickly. Now I'm telling you the answer. You can match your answers with mine. The answer is 75. Let's add another numbers. It's 33 plus 27. Just do it quickly. Do it fast. You have to do it orally. Don't use paper and pen. So the answer is 60. Next is 19 plus 61. Hurry up. Do it fast. The answer is... Okay, you can take some more time. Yeah. The answer is 80. Next pair of numbers is 34 plus 63. Can you add them? Yes. The answer is 97. Let's have another number. It's 72 plus 56. Now these numbers are big. So I hope you need some more time. Okay, take your time. Hurry up. Now I tell you the answer. The answer is 128. I hope you all are getting your answers correct. Now I'm giving you another pair of numbers. This will be the last one. It is 48 plus 42. Hurry up, just do it fast. Now I'm telling you its answer. Its answer is 90. So students, in this part of the chapter, we studied how we can add some numbers in our mind. I hope and I'm sure you all might have been feeling like experts in counting numbers orally. In the next part, we will study a story and I hope you will enjoy that story and learn a lot from that story. Thank you.